Hello guys, this is me again. I'm back from a trip to Germany. I went to a couple of flea markets the past week. Yesterday it was a Monday. I was driving to Germany to my good friend Michael and I bought a lot of stuff. He was a former dealer on eBay for military items and reenactment stuff. I also did some reenacting and he decided to quit being a dealer because the prices are way too low. And he's also in the music business, and that career is taking off. So I wish him the best of luck with that. And I want to show you some stuff I have gotten over in Germany and what I have bought on eBay. Sometimes when the shipping is very expensive, I ship it to his address and then it's a lot cheaper for me. And last time I was there was over 4 months ago. So this is 4 months of eBay on Germany for me, plus some old inventory I bought from my friend Michael. Okay, this is a complete set of the war diaries of the Oberkommando der Wehrmacht. It's a complete set. I bought it from him for €5. I'm gonna keep it. This is an old picture framed. And it's from the Reichswehr era, because they don't have an eagle on the uniform. If you can see it. No eagle on the uniform. No eagle on the cap. So it's the Weimar period. It's between World War I and World War II. Nicely framed. Period done. There's a stamp. Okay. This is some junk from unpacking. Okay guys, here are some field shirts. I'm going to sell it for reproduction purposes. Fußlappen, they used it in the Second World War. They used it in the East German Army. They used it in the Russian Army until the 1960s. It's instead of socks, you put those on your feet and you don't have trench foot. So obviously, because the Russian army used it until the 1960s, and even within the 1960s, it's a very well improvised item. I'm going to sell those for reenactment purposes. These are Mützenkordel for officer, East German. You can use them for reproduction Wehrmacht, an old field canteen. Or sanitator, Brotbeutel, the soldier carried that to carry his daily supplies with him. These are East German, these are emergency organization pieces. Going to sell those for reproduction and these for the normal East German stuff. I've got a reproduction Ritterkreuz, going to keep it. I'm never going to find a real one, so then a replica will do. This is a World War I banner, bought it for €5. I have 10 of these. I'm going to sell them as a reproduction or as Bundeswehr. I'm going to sell them one piece at a time, so this is for about a year work. Original K98 pouch, 1940, made in Berlin. A West German ammo box, and I have some straps for the Eskeshir. Some Garand belts, reproduction East German winter boots with felt. I've got a US uniform ACU, going to sell that. I have 4 old military staff maps. This one is dated 1965. This one is dated 1958. This one is dated 1974. And this one is dated 1981. Bought those for €1 a piece. This one is on the back of one that has been made invalid. It's pretty interesting. Bought them for €1 a piece plus shipping. Don't know if I'm gonna sell it because they're not quite that old, but I think there are a couple of reenactors who maybe want to use it for filming purposes or just for their put it on the table. Here's a US Army patch, ACU, got a magazine, got a book. I always buy books very cheap. It's in a foreign language, it's in French. I don't speak French, but pictures speak for itself. A lot of info. Going to read it. If I don't can use it, then I'm gonna sell it. A lot of useful pictures of the Swiss Army bicycle troops. Never seen those guys, but you see the bikes on eBay from time to time. It's a French magazine and it covers about all things military, police, survival, all kinds of interesting stuff. Then, something I've been searching for a long while, because they were not allowed to sell it without outside the United States. It's a Night Desert Camo pants. They used it in the Gulf War. They say you cannot be detected with infrared. And this one is dated 1981, so it's a quite early piece. Very fond of it. Never gonna sell it, gonna keep it. And now is the search on for the jacket. Here is a firefighter's belt from the 1970s, borrowed from my friend in Germany. I don't collect fireman stuff, but I think it will be a good seller, because this is a model, they don't use it anymore. That's the bag for the axe. That's if you have to climb up a tree or something like that, you can fasten yourself. Police patches from Germany, from Berlin, from the Voluntary Police Reserve, Schutzpolizei, a cap badge. This is a cap badge from Hungary in the communist era, distinguished unit insignia, one for dentist, Second World War patch, 75th Infantry Division. This is major for mechanized infantry, Russia. US Air Force patch, gonna keep it. K4 badge, gonna sell it. This is an interesting piece. East German, it's for the National State Security. It says Wache, so that's for a guard standing post at that place. Going to keep it. I've never seen one up. I've seen them up for sale, but never as cheap as I got in that. This is a memory piece dated 23 of April 1981. Officers and non-commissioned officers, 5th Division. It's given to the commander who is going with retirement from a brigade commander. And it says Lieutenant General of Infantry. And it's given by a brigade general. Then I have one from the police from the old days, 1980s. I have pocket insignia for the Panzer Artillery Battalion, so it's an Armored Corps Artillery Battalion 405 in Germany. And I have, too bad it's missing the lid, but I got it for a cheap price. East German with the Urkunde, and it's made out to a Unterleutnant der Volkspolizei, so it's a junior lieutenant of the East German police, Rudi Gerth, and it's given him on the 1st of March 1966, so it's quite early piece. And then I have a gas mask. Second World War. It's missing the long strap. I've put on a short strap because it was missing that also. I have a Second World War helmet. Too bad it has two little holes. It's been painted after the war, but still a nice piece. I've got a Second World War helmet with decals, 3rd Infantry Division. It has a modern liner, but it's okay. This is for 1980s police cap from the Holland, It's made for an adjutant, so it's NCO. I have two old toy trucks from Shell. I have a field telephone from the Bundeswehr, so it's the German army from West Germany, 1960s. This is some stuff I'm gonna list today. An old 100 mark bill from 1935. I have an old money bag from the Reichsbank from the World War. This is stuff I'm gonna keep for myself. It's for an officer, Luftwaffe, 1960s, 1970s. It's a 58, so it's a good size. This one I also didn't have. It's Pioniere, so the engineer department from the Germans, dated November 1984. Big size, it's a size 60, so I'm gonna keep that. This one is also going in my collection. I have about 10 of these packs. It's the fuel you use for the S-bit kocher. I have an old newspaper dated 1941. It's about the torpedo, the snelboten. This is also stuff I'm gonna list. I have multiple of those, but list them one at a time. Then here's some small stuff, some epaulets. That's going up in the collection. I have to search it, but it's also engineer department from the West German Army. I have verbandpakken, but the funny thing is it's for the customs department. It says Bundesgrenzschutz, so I've never seen that one. Dated June 1968. If I find them cheap, I buy them for 1-2 euros a piece. Going to try, it's a crazy thing of me, but I'm trying to collect one from every year, something I just like to do, some from time to time. Some old how do you call those in English, Hosenträger, you use it to that your pants doesn't fall from your ass, you know. This is some stuff I have to clean up. It's all from how it arrived, and then I will show you something different. This is Wachtstiefel, so when they were on guard on the Eastern Front. I've got those from my buddy Michael. I paid 40 euros, 17 euro item each day. I'm going to put it up in the winter sales. I've got a bag of rifle slings for the PPSH-41 for the Russian submachine gun, made of cloth and leather. Have to look up for markings. I'm gonna sell those one at a time. And then I have here something special. My buddy didn't know where it was. It's some kind of pillow, and it's clearly marked with a German eagle from the Air Force, 1939. I think this is a pillow that went into an aircraft. It's 5 or 10, I think 10 euros. If you feel in it, it's like straw or horse's hair in it. So it's quite old, it's definitely original. If you can feel it, smell it, touch it. I think this went in a Junker 52, which dropped the airborne forces over Holland, Belgium and Luxembourg in the 1940s during the Blitzkrieg. Gonna keep it, gonna research it, probably never gonna sell it because it's a one-off item. I don't even see it in the museums, and I have visited quite a lot of museums. Okay guys, I also bought a lot of stuff that is not able to sell now, but in the winter time. These are all boxes of scarves, wool gloves, yeah, all for reenacting purposes, but you're only able to sell it with the Battle of the Bulge event or something like that. So that's going up my attic, and when it's getting real cold, I'm going to sell them one at a time. Here are some other stuff from reenacting pieces. gonna keep it, sell it one piece at a time. These are the short straps for the gas mask. Those are for our visor cap, the leather straps. Some escachiers, some I have Blanco dog tags from the German army. That's for the visor, a replica shoulder board. So stuff I'm going to sell. These are all also field blouses from the Italian army. It looks like the Africa Corps, so I'm going to sell those one piece at a time. So you see all the stuff scattered throughout my living room, in the hallway, in the stairs. I'm going to repack it, sell what I'm able to sell now. The other stuff I'm going to put away, and in the autumn time I'm putting it back, and I sell it online one at a time. So a lot of helmets, a lot of clothing, a lot of field gear. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe, comment, and you have some interesting other stuff to say. I'm open for suggestions. Okay, bye bye.